take it back all the way back to 2005, real quick. You had the maddest first couple of years as a band that I think you could possibly have in terms of how much that happened to you so quickly. Do you look back on those years with fondness? How do you look back when you look back at that time, 2005?
I try not to, Annie. But yeah, certain things about it are like unforgettable. Like, you know, I remember relatively vividly the like when we had a number one single and Bet You Look Good on the Dance Floor, and like I remember that moment quite vividly, just to repeat vividly again for the second and now third time, folks. In the pub in High Green, we were all as friends, and you know, like I've reflected on that story sufficiently, I'm sure. But there's moments like that. I remember the sort of roar that went up in the pub when it like came on, and it was like.
Yeah.
Well, I suppose it was the number two record that got revealed.
Yeah,
and then
you
knows,
were
right. That's
yeah,
it. Yeah. So, and sort of that moment, probably with the single, suddenly began to be like out the window. Like you just don't. It's like, well, who knows now? What's next? Like,
You were good in those early stages, as in the band. We're good at knowing when to say no and knowing how to not get caught up in the hype. And it's one of the things I've always really liked about your band, is that there's a kind of contrariness and in kind of intrinsic contrariness to what you do, where you kind of subvert the hype into humor and find ways to laugh at stuff, maybe to be able to deal with it in your head. So I don't know, you tell me.
I think that's exactly what it was. Probably a lot of that was to do with the concern that like the floor was going to fall out at any moment. You started to, like you said, treat the hype, if you want to call it that, in that way.
Do you ever go back and revisit stuff that you've made? Is that, you know, as a band, do you ever go back and be like, oh my goodness, we did that?
Just like YouTubing Miss Anne and that.
Well, maybe. Or just listen to old stuff.
Oh, yeah. No, yeah. I do that. I've done that. I think sometimes that's that can be helpful. Like, in fact, just recently, it was one night actually at Le Fret. We kind of flicked through some of our old records, like thinking about like how we were going to, you know, what we might play on the tour and that.
Yeah.
But yeah, it's like that, it doesn't happen very often, that. Certainly not like the four of us like together doing that. But it was quite amusing that night.
I bet. Is there arguments about who wants to play what?
No, I don't remember there being many arguments that night about it. There was more just kind of, there were a few lyrics that went by where I was a bit like, there weren't much of it. I don't even know, a few like musical bits probably as well that were a bit like, nah, I'd probably leave that one out. But we'll see whether we get away with that.
I wonder, does anyone have a grand plan, you know, for albums beyond this day?
Truthfully, no. I'm pretty much focused on this week now. Just you know, I've got his first gig tomorrow, night at a time, for the moment, I think. And then, yeah, there's no grand plan that
no
I can.
Grand.